I am Amethyst Lunatari. Welcome to Let's Play Midnight Scenes, The Highway. This is a very short little game, so this is going to be another little part one of one. You can find this for $3 on Steam. This was the first game they released. I forget this guy's name. Octavi. I was going to write it down, but I wrote down other stuff. This is the first game they released, that he released. It's a one-man studio. This was re-released in 2020. I believe originally came out in 2017, but he did it with the... He upgraded it somehow into a special edition. And he's done a few of these Midnight Scenes games and some other small games, so... They're horror adventure kind of games. I guess more adventure than horror. I forgive my squeaky chair here. Sure you can hear that. The options are not much. Music volume, sound effects volume, and the language be English. You can change it to any number of languages. New game. Yeah, 2017. So the funny thing is I had to cap this at 60 frames a second by using the nVidia. The nVidia settings. And add the game in and cap it at 60 frames a second because it was running at like something like Octavi Navarro. That's the name. Hopefully I'm not butchering that. It sounds like it's still a bit loud for you guys to hear me, so let's put it down some more. But, yeah, it was running at like 7,000 frames a second or something like that. And it was interfering with my Windows Aero desktop theme. And Windows was asking me if I want to switch to basic and stuff. And I'm like, is it because this is running at 7,000 frames a second? So, it sounds just as loud, doesn't it? It still sounds loud. Is this working? Let's just see if it's working. I'll put it all the way down and see if it's working. Zoom. Oh, okay. It's all the way down. It's... I had to put it way down. Like, see it... Hear a difference. I was really just testing it. Claire Barnes, age 29. She's about to discover the kinds of horrors that lurk in the darkness on a deserted road. This would be a great, you know, Twilight Zone narrator to come in and narrate this, but I can't sound like him. Rod Serling, sorry. A flat tire, spelled T-Y-R-E, for some reason, delayed Claire's trip. Little does she suspect how this incident will change her life forever, as well as her perception of reality. Now this is the kind where you can highlight on interactable things. The only thing we can interact with is here. Turns that off. There's no good stations out here, wherever she is. Tonight's episode, The Highway. So I do plan on playing the other two. The other one's just called Episode 2, and another, the last one's called The Nanny. And then he has two other games unrelated to Midnight Scenes. An unexpected obstacle. A new delay for Claire. She might need to find some help if she wants to resume her journey as soon as possible. Fortunately, she notices a signal pointing to a nearby emergency phone. Let's wish her luck. Good luck, because you can't get there. To make her repeatedly shock herself. So we can't interact with anything over here, because it just hurts. This is blind, by the way. I've just looked around this area, so that's kind of creepy. We can get back in the car, but for no reason. Alright, we can do that, and then that one's ripped off. So we got missing kids. It looks normal. Gonna go further that way. There's another missing kid here. Or is it the same kid? Kinda looks like the same kid. It's putting up a lot of signs. And this is the extent to which I played. Oh, that goes back out. I thought this... Okay, that's an arrow. It's part of the scenery, though. Get out of here. Glass, blood, and a photo. Is that the kid who's missing? Well, it's blood not on him, but on the photo. I guess we can't take that. Oh, it's locked. Oh, we got rope. Piece of rope. What else? What'd I get? Oh. I got a hammer. Can't bust a lock with the hammer? I guess I can't take the shovel. All this stuff's wrapped in itself. Kind of looks like you just slip it out of there. Okay. Maybe we'll find a key somewhere. What is this? Anatomy of a scarecrow or something? This goes here? This is this thing. Some kind of pulley? I don't understand. Oh. Right? A scarecrow. So wait a second. Oh, that's the photo under that. Alright. Can't combine them. We'll fix the car with the hammer. Oh boy. Yeah, I don't like that very much. Bonk. Body parts? No, broom. I can't take the other part. So let's see if we can combine some things. So we can open that as well. So what am I going to do with the half a broom handle? She shrugs. She doesn't want to go in because of that? Creepy. So what's the purpose of that? Wait. It shows here, right, these are the arms, so the arms can be put in three different positions, like I just did. So I can't do anything else with it. Okay. Oh. I have no idea why I'd want to do any of that stuff, but I did it. Or I tried to, anyway. So that's what knocked that off, into. That's what knocked that over. Even though this is much further down the road. Just want to see if it changed. Yeah, I can't really do anything here. Shrugs. She shrugs in exasperation. Let's try the. That sounds spooky all of a sudden. Okay, so she can't just open that for some reason. What am I supposed to do with the string and the hammer? And a broken mop. I'm stumped already. Don't want to mess with your car, huh? I can't believe how stumped I am. Can't go any further than this. The clue's gotta be this. Oh, I make an arm for it, don't I? Out of the broom handle? Oh. It fell off. Oh, I picked it up. It looked like it fell off behind the fence, though. All right, so we want to put it here. Anyway. Here, and then tie the string around. And that makes the gate open, really? It's pretty elaborate. Oh boy. Door. Could go anywhere else. We can only walk straight across. We can't go that way. Boy. The boy's not in the picture. Oh, there's a baby there. I guess that was before. Now the baby's born. Getting in the car that ended up crashing into the thing. I just turned the TV off. On. Okay, that's what. There's blood in here. There's a foot. Can the TV still be turned on? Yeah. Does that affect this? No. Honk. Okay. Oh wait, I didn't look at this picture. Alright, that's them making that scarecrow thingy. I'm in the back. I got a board, a wood board. Oh. Alright, I got a nail, and I guess we don't want the horseshoe. Wood with nail. Hammer it in. No, okay. Wood with nail, I got. I like seeing if we can combine items, that kind of thing. No can reach. Can we climb? No. We're gonna put in our own board. Wait. Looking like she was starting to do it. There we go. And she automatically used the hammer, and the hammer's gone. We destroy the hammer. Okay. Is that a body there? Behind her. We want the light? Oh, okay. I don't know what that is there. Okay. Gas lamp. Oh, so we can see in that room. Yep, we saw a foot. Before. Footprints leading up. So got hurt and ran over here. Tried to bandage himself up, but it didn't work out, apparently. There's a key. And his neck. Small key. Okay. I want to take that. I guess we don't take that back. So the key... Oh, for the wire cutters. So spooky, though. I don't want these. Okay. Cable cutter. Now we don't want to look at the box. Heading on foot. Well, that's horrible. Did we see in that accident and then walked home and try to bandage himself? Woods? I don't know what that is. Something. A trail going into the woods? Not sure what that means. What's that? Let me make a. She circled something. A man and a. Someone else? The back of a man, looks like. I don't know what I'm looking at. Alright. We'll take an EKG or something. Well, there's the phone. Not working. Surprise, surprise. Sorry, guys. Oh, she got shocked by her. What is this? A photo of the boy with the horse. That's the boy who's missing. Claire Barnes, age 29. With great effort, she finally managed to push aside the fallen power pole and resume her journey. Still terrified, she stopped at the first gas station to contact the authorities and inform them about the disturbing events she had witnessed. The police found nothing out of the ordinary on that stretch of road, no signs of any crash or the presence of any mysterious kid. The man living in the farm was found a bit drunk, but in good condition. A bit drunk, but in good condition? Not a single word was written in any newspaper about the horrors Claire witnessed that night. She went on with her life, trying to convince herself that she wasn't crazy after all, that she probably just saw something not meant to be seen. Well done. I enjoyed it. About 20 minutes. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. I plan on playing some more of these games. I don't know how this ends. If you get dumped at desktop, always seek adventure. Guess it just stops here. So anyway, yeah, these are great little games because I play, in case you guys don't know, I'm new to the channel, I play a lot of really long games, so it's great to just throw some really super short games in there just to spice things up. And plus I have a lot of book reading. You know, I read books as I come across them in games and make separate videos for them. So sometimes between those book readings, there's a few days here and there, so it's good to throw in some stuff just to fill in the space until the next book comes along, if that makes any sense. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in another Let's Play, I hope, and always seek adventure.